you keep turning me on. It ain't my fault you got me so gone. It ain't my fault I'm not leaving alone. It ain't my fault you're not leaving alone. It ain't my fault.
So today we're at Kroger, and I wanted to kind of lead you through things that I have on my shopping list because it's meal prep day. And then I also wanted to point out a couple of other things maybe that I'm not gonna actually prep. Good things to look for, good go-to foods when you feel like you're in a bind. So here we go. Got the list. Here we go. So we got cucumbers. And I like baby carrots, but they also just go great with any meal and they're super easy to prepare. All I'm gonna do later is cut them up, throw them in a bowl with some seasonings, shake around the bowl, and then I throw that on top of lunch. Boom. Cold potatoes for me, huge carbohydrate staple. These I have with lunch with chicken. The way I'm gonna prepare these later is to just boil them and throw them in with a bunch of veggies, some butter. Good to go. Bananas, excellent pre, post workout carbohydrate. I'm going not organic on these because in general with fruits, if it has a peel that you're not gonna eat, basically the only thing that's different between this and organic is the fact that they don't spray pesticides, and I'm gonna peel this off. I'm not gonna eat the pesticide. Cuties, another really good source of carbohydrates if you want some pre or post workout fuel. I like these because they're super easy to peel and get. We actually drain a lot of vitamin C in the workout, so to replenish, it's nice to have these at post-workout.
Let's go to beef
and chicken. Usually I get a different kind of beef. One that I typically get is actually locally sourced. It's not organic, but I'm okay with that, because a lot of the things that identify organic, 9 times out of 10, they are almost as similar as the other natural beef and chicken products. We've got the 90-10, it's 90% lean, 10% fat. That's probably gonna be your leanest source of beef. For my chicken selection, I usually get the brand called Purdue. Again, they don't have it right now, but the Kroger Simple Truth is also good. The reason I'm not going organic is similar to the reason why I didn't go organic on the beef. The terms that identify organic for chicken are almost exactly the same for something that is natural. A little bit of marketing. We go through and we see things like this. Boom, it's gluten-free. It's got green. Why these are typically not maybe as healthy as they would seem. We go in here, we see not terrible ingredients. The problem is we have no idea when this was made. It was frozen. And the fresher our food can be, the better. So it's easy to get kind of foiled by this packaging. Honestly, when you look at it, there's no vitamin and mineral content. You're like not really getting anything out of it. This tiny, tiny package is already well over half of the total sodium intake that you want to have for the day. That's why making this on your own will be a lot better for you. These types of things, however, are great. This is a really easy way for you to get veggies into your diet. You don't want to deal with cooking the Brussels sprouts. All you have to do is steam these or throw them in the microwave, whatever. Super easy. So for me personally, I eat cereal a lot. I want to talk about the difference between organic and non-organic. We're paying a much higher price for. So we'll go to the ingredients list. We have whole grains, oats, cane sugar, rice, blah, blah, blah. And it's really short, which is great. Now, let's go find a non-organic cereal and see what the differences are. We were talking about the difference between an organic cereal and a non-organic cereal. We go over to the ingredients list. Whole grain oats, sugar, it's got cornstarch. There aren't a whole lot of differences between the organic and the non-organic. What you've got to pay attention to is a crazy list of ingredients. These are the kind of cereals that we are probably gonna wanna stay away from, because you can see all of these added natural and artificial flavors, the colorings. Those are the things that we wanna stay away from. I like these a lot. This is an excellent way to supplement. I have these in the morning It's a great way for me to drink 18 ounces of water really fast. That way I'm hydrated. Super good for your gut health, and then in return, your immune health. I just think this is funny. It's called detox water. What the heck does that even mean? Like, what are we detoxing? We have toxins in our body, right, that we need to detox with cleanses, all of this. No, your body does that for you naturally, so you don't have to buy any product that says detox on it. Your body has a liver. That's what the liver is for. If you don't have a liver, then maybe you should worry about buying the things that say detox on it. But for everybody else who does have a liver, don't worry about it. Spinach. Getting organic because there's no pesticide sprayed on it. And this is super easy to throw in your morning egg mix. Great way to get some veggies. If you love your bagels, Dave's Killer Bread. Shamelessly endorsing this. It has a lot of protein. They're organic, which is super important for a food that like this is definitely processed. So all of the ingredients in it are good ingredients. Definitely hype these up. I was on this kick for a long time. Kind of on the same train as like bagels and breads. You look at these. These look not terrible, right? I mean, you would think that they would be healthy. And at this point, we should all understand that health is relative, but there are bad things in foods that make them things that you will want to avoid. So for instance, I think it's ridiculous that we can find sucralose, an artificial sweetener, in English muffins. Obviously, again, that's something that you would want to avoid. Canned fruits and veggies can be a really great source, especially if you just don't have the time to prepare. But if we look at something like this, this seems kind of tasty. If we look at the ingredients, it's got added sugars. We want to stay away from anything that's got added sugars in it if it's canned, because it just shouldn't be there. I realize this isn't quite the same, and it might take a little bit more prep time, but we're looking at cut green beans, less prep time there. It says no salt added, so we know that it doesn't have a whole bunch of sodium in it, and it's got zero added sugars. Green light, good to go. This also goes for pretty much anything that's packaged, but another big thing is gonna be soups. If you look at it, you wanna make sure there's no added sugars and that there is low sodium. You can see that for soups. We can see it in ketchups and condiments and all other sorts of things. So those are the things that you wanna look out for. I use these a lot when I'm in a bind. I ran out of rice, whatever. I need some sort of carb. These are awesome because they're easy to prepare. And then also, if we look at the ingredients list, it's got nothing weird in it. When we look at something like this, however, it's got 700 milligrams of sodium. That's one serving. There's two servings in this. And you can see this giant list of additives. One that I see is corn syrup solids. Why do we want that in our cheddar broccoli rice? We don't. Virgin coconut oil, cold press unrefined, meaning the least processed possible. This is an excellent source of fats. In the evening, when I have my evening protein shake, throw a little bit of this in there, especially because my protein is chocolate flavored. It's amazing. So if you're ever looking for another source of fats, or if you just want coconut oil, this is the way to go. Another staple for me, source of carbohydrates, good source of fiber. It is organic. And when we go to the ingredients list, all it is rolled oats, cane syrup, natural flavor, sea salt. So it's good to go. Yeah, it's got added sugars in it, but in the case of an athlete who needs a lot of carbohydrates and fast carbohydrates after a workout, this is great. All right, so let's talk about yogurt for a second, Greek yogurt. Honestly, it's a great way to get protein. Sometimes it's also a great way to get carbohydrates. This one is relatively low. It's only 12 grams of carbs per. And the nice thing about this is obviously no sugar added, and it's sweetened with stevia, which is a natural sweetener. Also, the active cultures in these probiotics, good for gut health and immune health, like we were talking about earlier.
Never.
This is how they get you. Supports healthy cholesterol levels.
This is not good for you.
All of these crazy ingredients. This is a fake food, okay? Butter is not bad for you. But there are some butters that we do want to stay away from, like this. Nice. Edible butter, no good. Other things we want to stay away from. Salted butter,
obviously, for added sodium.
Spray butter, zero calories. I mean, this is as fake as we could get for something. That when we're putting this into our body, stay away from this. This is what we want. Grass-fed, pasture-raised, made in the USA. Excellent. On eggs, free range. Free range means is that the chickens are able to roam, that they're eating the things that they should eat, like bugs, and they're getting all the nutrients that they should, which is then putting the nutrients into their eggs. White eggs, it's bleach. Okay, so they're bleaching that to make the color. Just stay away from that. You don't want bleach on your eggs. Yeah, it's the shell, it's the outside, but that can seep, open up the pores, and that can get into the egg. Take some of these white eggs, some of these just regular eggs, and do a yolk color test with maybe the organic eggs or the free-range eggs. If you notice a richer, deeper orange, that's gonna be more mineral and vitamin rich. You notice kind of a more yellowy, not so great looking colored yolk, then that is gonna be the opposite. It's gonna be mineral and vitamin deficient. So we talked about a lot of stuff today. A couple of rules of thumb when we're at the grocery store. Stay on the perimeter, which usually has the freshest whole food things. None of the packages, none of the frozen stuff is on the perimeter. That's the best place to be. We've also talked about a lot about what's bad for you. I don't want you to take this and think, oh, I've got to go throw out everything in my pantry now. I've got to, you know, completely change everything. Take small steps. If the option is not there for you to get all of the free-range, organic, grass-fed, then go step by step. Maybe start by just getting some whole vegetables and cooking them. And maybe you're starting to cook your chicken. Whatever it is, we want to take small incremental steps. And then also, I just hope this gave you a decent idea of what to look for in the grocery store, what's maybe going to help fit your diet.